Before I show you how I made these drawers, I would like to give you a quick overview about them. I will start with the movement of these drawers. I have used 4 independent wheels, non-rotatable, to slide these boxes in and out. Instead of fitting these wheels directly on the surface of the base, which would have reduced the storage space, instead I made these pockets and fitted the wheel in them, just leaving enough gap for movement. I made 4 of these drawers for my king size bed, and if you notice, more than 90% of the space below the bed is utilized for storing. The face sheet of this drawer is of the same solid wood material which I have used for making this bed. And for making all the other sections, I have used plywood and painted the surface later. This is the 3D model representing the actual drawer. I will be using this model frequently in this video to aid my presentation. So first, I will cut these 5 sections of the drawer. For that, I used 18mm plywood, and then with the help of my plunge circular track saw, I cut all these 5 pieces to the final required dimension. For now, I will keep all these plywood cut sections aside and will cut these 3 pieces required for each wheel housing. And in total, I need 4 wheel housings for a single drawer. I kept the dimension of the wheel housing such that the wheels once installed in this housing are protruded by 2 to 3mm from the bottom surface of the drawer. And I kept the width of the housing sufficient enough to accommodate the wheels and also the required space around the wheels for ease of installation with screws at the later stage. Then, as a raw material for the wheel housing, I used waste solid wooden blocks lying with me and did the rib cutting along length on my table saw. Later, I used sled to do the cross cut for all the pieces. And then finally sanded to smooth all the surfaces and the sharp edges using my belt sander. Then I took the base of the drawer to cut the openings for the wheels at all the 4 corners. For reference, I used the side housing pieces for marking prior to cutting. Then I carefully adjusted the rib fence to the width of the opening required and secured a wooden piece behind as a stopper to control the required depth of cut. This way, in 2 settings, I cut all the 4 sides of the openings consistently. Then using the handsaw, or you could even use a jigsaw, I cut the small portion left behind from the circular nature of the table saw blade. And as I was building 4 drawers at a time, I repeated the same process for all the 4 base planks of the drawer. Then I made the pocket holes on all the respective plywood sections using my Craig K5 jig. And I repeated the process on all the required sections, mainly on the bottom, back, and the front portion of the drawer. Now, before installing these 3 pieces together to make the wheel housing, marking and punching the wheel location on the housing is a very important step at this stage before beginning the installation, as it would be difficult to get the perfect wheel alignment in the assembled condition later. So I kept the 2 side sections and marked the boundaries. Then with the help of tri-square, I aligned the wheels 90° and marked the 4 centers and later punched the locations. Then I used 2 screws each to secure the side sections. But before that,
I marked the location for the screws on the blocks and drilled 3 mm pilot holes before passing the actual screws to avoid cracks in these narrow pieces of wood. Also, of the two screw sizes I had, the left shown was too large and the right was little short. As I wanted the screws to enter maximum into the plywood, so I made the counter bore on all the pieces to accommodate the screw sufficient enough into the plywood below.
Then I applied wooden glue and secured the pieces in place with the help of a clamp, and then finally I secured the blocks with the screws. Also, to get the right end of plane, you can make this temporary arrangement as I made by joining two small pieces of plywood together with the help of pocket hole screws. This helped to place the wheel housing blocks more accurately in their positions. I carefully aligned the plywood sections and used quick grip clamps to hold the sections together and permanently secured them with screws in the pocket holes drilled previously. I repeated the same process on the back panel and the front panel as well. Having all the pieces secured, now I will fix the roof of the wheel housing with the help of two screws. But before that, I marked the position of the screw location required for the roof section and drilled the pilot holes for the screws to pass. I also made countersink holes so that the countersink screws can fit flush on the surface. Then I passed the impression of the screw location on the blocks below the roof section and made pilot holes in the side sections as well, so that I don't end up cracking the blocks while passing the screws at this stage. Also, before passing the screws permanently, I applied wooden glue on both the sides of the blocks and then finally passed the screws to permanently fix and complete the wheel housing assembly. I repeated the process for all the four sides, and also finally I double checked the torque manually by hand. Then I applied wooden primer to all the plywood sections to give strong adhesion and coverage of the paint film later. After having applied one coat on all the four drawers I made, I left it to dry at room temperature overnight. Then I used oil-based enamel paint chocolate color as the final coat on all the plywood sections of the drawer. I applied two coats of this paint to get a consistent and even finish. This was a time-consuming process, as after every application, I had to allow the paint to dry before the next coat. I used 3 numbers 4x30 inch section of wood to make the face sheet. I already had the planing done and also passed all the 4 sides of the surface through the thicknesser. So now I just need to join these 3 pieces together to make the face sheet for my drawer. For that, I applied wooden glue at both the sides of the thickness and clamped them together with quick grip clamps and left it for curing overnight. Next day, for taking the face sheet for polishing, I trimmed the width to the final size on my table saw with the help of my sled by keeping 1 inch more either sides than the width of the drawer. And then I also cut the final height of the face sheet using my rib fence on my table saw and kept 2mm gap on the top and 2mm on the bottom. I then used orbital sander starting with 80 grit paper throughout the surface and then increased the paper grit to 180 to achieve a smooth and even surface. Wherever needed for more uneven and rough surface, I also used belt sander machine to speed up the sanding process but again switched back to orbital sander for final finish. I had applied Milliman gloss finish on the bed for which I made these drawers. So I matched the same polish and finish for the drawer face sheet as well. I will add the link in the description below for a detailed video on how I applied melamine polish, which will include the surface preparation as well. Please watch that video if you would like to know the polishing process of this face sheet. Now is the time for installing the wheels, which was accurately aligned and easy to install as I had already punched the holes in the beginning and had the perfect location for installing these wheels. I used pan head screws to secure the wheels and once I finished installing all the four wheels, I checked the movement of the drawer to make sure the movement is smooth without any interference. Then I fixed the face of the drawer, but before that I placed a 2mm spacer. In my case, I used these cards below the face sheet to attain the gap of 2mm and then temporarily secured the two parts together with the help of quick grip clamps. Also, before fastening with screws, I checked the movement to make sure there is no interference with the floor during movement. Then finally I secured the face to the body of the drawer using screws. In addition, I also secured the face sheet using the pocket holes from the bottom of the drawer. The drawer is incomplete without a knob or a handle, so I did the marking and drilling to install the knob for ease of push and pull of the drawer. Please do write your comments or if you have questions about this video. Thank you for being with me in this video and take care.